The most shocking scene in Martin Scorsese's The Irishman comes near the end. Spoilers. Mafia hitman Frank Sheeran, played by Robert De Niro, lures his best friend Jimmy Hoffa into an empty house. Hoffa realizes that something is wrong and heads for the door. Sheeran draws a gun and shoots Hoffa twice, plants the gun on his body, and flees. It's an incredible moment, but it's not the scene that shows why Robert De Niro is so incredible. That one comes a few minutes later. As Hoffa's disappearance hits the news, Sheeran decides to call Hoffa's wife, Jo, to make sure she's okay. His goal is to reassure Jo that everything's going to be fine, but as the man who pulled the trigger, he knows that's a lie. Throw in Frank's guilt over the murder, his grief over Hoffa's death, and the pressure of keeping the truth a secret, and he's very close to his breaking point. The scene that follows has no music, no flashy camera work, and no other actors. It's just De Niro, a telephone, and Joe's hysterical cries. It also happens to be one of the best things that De Niro has ever done.
Be strong, be positive, huh? Oh, okay, Joe, okay.
De Niro's biggest strength as an actor is the way he can say everything without actually saying anything. His characters mumble and stutter. Often, he talks around his lines instead of reciting them.
I was just doing a job to make some extra money. Yeah. Putting this place out of action. Putting this place out of commission.
However, thanks to De Niro's body language, it's easy to derive meaning from his half-finished words and tangential thoughts. That's one of the reasons De Niro was spot-on casting for a young Vito Corleone in The Godfather Part II. Marlon Brando, who originated the role, had a similar acting style.
Afraid I was, I never wanted this for you.
And yet, despite Sheeran's babbling incoherence, it's completely clear what's going on in Frank's mind. Hoffa's death is weighing on him, and while we've seen in the past that Sheeran is an accomplished and skilled liar, the guilt is simply too much for him to bear. It's the perfect example of what makes De Niro's acting so unique and memorable. Oh, and by the way, that phone call between Frank and Joe? In the original script, it's less than a quarter of a page long. De Niro has two lines. Joe, it's Frank. Whatever you need, anything I can do, I'm here. And it's gonna be all right. I'm sure he's all right. That's it. And instead of those simple platitudes, we get this.
You know, you gotta think positively. It's just, you know, it ain't that long. You just...
But do you know
he's... No. I mean, you know, maybe he did something like the Joe Bananas thing where he, you know, had himself kidnapped and then came back, but he wasn't hurt, nothing happened. Maybe he just felt, you know, he wanted to get to clear his head a bit, but you gotta just think that it's gonna be okay.
De Niro has a history of doing this kind of thing. Remember, he's the same guy who improvised the mirror scene in Taxi Driver, birthing one of the most iconic lines of dialogue in history.
You talking to me?
It's hardly surprising that De Niro is the one who transformed the scene from a perfunctory phone call into the Irishman's rawest and most honest moment. It's impossible to talk about De Niro's turn in The Irishman without mentioning his director and his co-stars. Including The Irishman, Robert De Niro and Martin Scorsese have made 9 movies together. It's De Niro's 7th with Joe Pesci. Meanwhile, De Niro and Al Pacino have only worked together 4 times, and even then, they didn't share any scenes in The Godfather Part II and only one in Heat.
Yeah, it is what it is. It's that, or we both better go do something else, pal.
I don't know how to do anything else.
Neither do I.
Still, they're close friends. They both burst into Hollywood around the same time, making a name for themselves in the new Hollywood films that defined cinema in the late 60s and 70s. And as they navigated their newfound fame together, they quickly became buddies.
What do you say I buy you a cup of coffee?
Yeah, sure, let's go.
The Irishman is a movie about getting older and having to say goodbye to the people you love, and those feelings define the film behind the scenes, too. Before The Irishman, De Niro and Scorsese hadn't made a movie together since Casino, and that came out almost 25 years earlier. Pesci had been retired for close to 20 years when he filmed The Irishman, and De Niro and Pacino weren't sure they would ever have a chance to work together again. When Frank hangs up the phone and bows his head, finally mourning Hoffa, it's hard not to get the sense that De Niro is also saying goodbye to Pacino, Pesci, Scorsese, and all of his other regular collaborators over the years. The Irishman hopefully won't be De Niro's last movie, but it's still a wonderful tribute to his long, prolific career. Robert De Niro has one of the most famous faces in Hollywood. In fact, to a certain extent, that's the entire point of The Irishman, which takes place over multiple decades and uses digital de-aging technology to make De Niro, Al Pacino, and Joe Pesci look like they're half their ages. It's a magic trick that works especially well if you already know what these actors looked like as young men.
What's that about?
So when you see a young Frank Sheeran, you're also seeing Travis Bickle and Jake LaMotta. Later, Sheeran bears more than a passing resemblance to Jack Walsh and Max Cady. By the time he murders Hoffa, Frank is about 55 years old, and in those scenes, De Niro looks almost exactly like he did in Ronin and Meet the Parents. You can't help but make the association. Those characters are just all so memorable.
I have nipples, Greg. Could you milk me?
Okay, could we change the subject, perhaps?
That should be distracting, but it actually works in The Irishman's favor. See, Frank Sheeran has a lot in common with many of De Niro's other characters. Not only is he a gangster, but he's stoic and masculine and exudes an understated cool. We've seen De Niro play a character like this many, many times before. And yet, we've never seen those characters succumb to guilt and sorrow like Sheeran does here. Goodfellas' Jimmy Conway never had to deal with the psychological repercussions of his violent acts. Neither did Rupert Pupkin, Sam Rothstein, or plenty of others. Because of the digital de-aging, when Sheeran loses it on the phone, it feels like all of De Niro's past characters have hit the breaking point. In many ways, The Irishman is a celebration of De Niro's on-screen history, and the weight he brings to the screen makes the scene all the more powerful. Thanks for watching! Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.